started us with some very, very basic stuff. And then Renee said we're doing intermediate forms. I thought now we're obviously ready for some advanced. And we messed up our time where we don't have enough the same space of time, but since it's advanced, I'll do all the advanced stuff in half the time. Because we're ready for that. Right? So what I'm going to do is that we earlier were just starting in this feet parallel stance or horse stance or ready stance or whatever, and I'm going to just try it now with 1 foot forward, and we'll do it with our right foot forward. And this is one of the things that you learn in Tai Chi right away. The first teacher came up and said to press in the big toe. And then the second teacher came up to grab and curl the toes. So, you know, if you only go to one Tai Chi class, you don't get confused. But if you go to more than one, it's a long history of confused. So what I'm going to do is just let you do whatever you like with your toes, whichever teacher you're trying to impress. Do their thing. And I won't say too much about the toes, so just leave them how they are. And if you remember, or for a moment, we'll go through something that's iterative. And if you feel like, oh, I wonder what this is like curling the toes. I wonder what it feels like if I remind myself to press in the big toe and just play with it. Because a big part of this is really is playing this, right? The people that we hold in regard as the masters, the people that we have the cool paintings of and stuff in our schools, they didn't have teachers, right? Like the very best people at this didn't have teachers, but they played, right? So the kid that's not picking up their coat up, they're your teacher, right? I mean, don't want to know that, but they're your teacher, right? So we'll bring the right foot forward. I like to keep both feet parallel here, but if you already studied Tai Chi, you may very well have your rear foot turned out a little bit, or indeed, if that's a little bit more comfortable in your back, or because your teacher's here watching you, like just do the way they like you to do it, and that's fine. So I'm going to go through a series. It's called Peng Lu Jian. You guys just learned Chinese in the last section, so I'll use some Chinese terms. And so I'm going to start with my arms like this. I'll just kind of do this facing you as well. Do this facing you as well. Good. And the general idea here is that this is an upgrade from this, right? This is ready for a fight if I had the mustache, right? This is ready for a fight. And this is also ready for a fight, but it's asking not to have that fight, right? So the overall feeling here is, hey. I mean, this is asking not to fight, hey man, what's the problem? But I'm also not ready. So there's this sense of ready. And the ready, you don't have to visualize like a knife in an alley and a person and their buddies and a stick. It doesn't have to be that kind of fight. It could just be, I've told them about the code, now I raise my voice, let's see what happens. It could just be energy coming towards you that you don't find particularly healthy. So from here, the way it'll start on the front leg, if you're sitting, just come forward on your chair enough that you can have a little bit of shift in your butt, just from front to back. It doesn't have to be a large motion. I'll do it large because I'm on stage. So from here, have a sense of fullness, right? Most of us have a hard time doing that in our relationships and in our wallets. So I'm just talking about in our bodies. Let's just start there. So the feeling that I want to have here is just this. And the way I usually teach this is that if I'm going to hug somebody, just about here, that feeling. We haven't hugged because then we'll kind of collapse and maybe coo, right? But it's that kind of feeling where we're just that moment. You feel your eyes, you feel your heart dissolve its armor. Maybe you feel a change in the shape of the body. So here we go. From here, try and have a sense of fullness. From that fullness, right, because it's full, there's no more room to fill, so it's only stuff coming towards the fullness, right? So that fullness is going to recede and allow towards the center that energy that's incoming from where we're facing, but the center rotates. So I'm inviting, allowing in this energy, right? So many of you that do Tai Chi, your form will look maybe more like this. I'm just doing my version. If you have a version, you kind of already see what I'm doing, you can do your version, it's no problem. So the idea here is just to get these ideas from full to maintaining full around this vertical center line. We talked about the Bai Hui and the Hu Yin, those two points. having that vertical line itself rotate as I remain full and don't resist what enters. From here, I'm going to shift back forward and let the face of the watch on the left hand rise. So at this point, we have this happening. You can do that same Dantian breath here that we were talking about here, if you'd like. You can even try it up that one yin linking vessel instead of both from here. Then I'm going to let that shoulder continue and come back and let the two hands meet. So the two hands meet above the heart, and I shift forward and they come towards my heart, towards my center. So I'm just facing here, just so you can see. Soft and gentle. From here, shift back. And I want to return to that filling, right? This is a motion here. This is G. This is about displacing, right? Good. And then I bring this energy, lead it down into the earth, and push. Good. So I'm going to just repeat while I have my legs on the front weight. And I just change my angle. So fullness, accepting and receding and rotating. Shift. Come back. This is called an angel's kiss. So I have this really soft sense here. And this is really bringing this energy up to this datsui point, which is this major yang. This is like, in fact, it translates in Chinese as giant hammer, right? So it's probably masculine, right? You know, so what we're doing is we're bringing this energy up, that dantian breath, and we're doing an angel's kiss, right? Like, nice little counterbalance to men, okay? So here, and then from there, we allow that energy towards the heart, right? That soft heart from that fullness. And then we displace, and the displacing that we want to have here is when the elevator doors open and you step in and are full, there has to be a displacement, right? There's other ways to make room in the elevator, right? Or don't shower. Right, come in with the hippie dog. Like, there's a lot of ways that you can make room, but that's not compassionate, right? That's just about what you want, and you can make that happen. But the idea in G, right, the term G here in Chinese is only used in the case of getting on a crowded train or an elevator. That's the term, they use it as squeeze. But the real sort of idea here is that I'm gonna make my way in through displacement, but it's compassionate displacement. Oh, you need a moment to take that step. Here, I'll hold that for you. If I could watch, I'm sorry about my backpack, and then you're in. So it's a compassionate displacement. So I brought this mindset from the datsui to the heart, and then shifting away. This is the compassionate displacement. From here, I'm gonna inhale, I'm gonna bring in energy towards the liver and the spleen, right? So if you want to just focus on the liver side, because that's what we're working on, that's fine. So you can breathe in just the same thing we were practicing with John. You can even hear. Good. And repeat. So I'll just do this twice more. So I'm not interested in you guys learning this well. And the reason is I've been teaching this for 30 years and none of my students can do it. I mean, it's because I can't. I mean, it's not like I have bad students, they have a bad teacher. So, but if you can go through a version of the motions and have just tune into these ideas, right? So fullness, acceptance while rotating and retreating, right, bringing the energy from the bringing the feminine to the masculine and bringing them both to the heart, compassionate displacement, and then inviting energy into the spleen and liver, or even just the lower body, the dantian, if you would want, the lower dantian, and then exhaling all of that. So we've kind of mixed up the recipe, and then we're at the end, I'm offering it to whomever. So twice more through, full. We want to maintain that full throughout, which is a little tough. Recede, accept, rotate. Right, this is that dantian breathing, so that we have that really yin breathing up to our lower center before we approach the neck, and then the heart, and then compassionate displacement. You can even think of the compassion, I'm retreating as I displace. It doesn't feel like what you'd think. Bringing the energy into the lower body and offering. Once more, and then we'll let Renee come up here. Again, if you have another version of this sequence represents 50% of the basic energies in Tai Chi. Just having this sequence, you're halfway there. The rest of the cool moves are just so your teacher can make a living. You know, fair. But if you get this, this is kind of half of it. This sequence in every Tai Chi form repeats itself over and over. They don't repeat this. It's like you do it twice and that's it. That's probably not the most, it's cool. Every move is probably cooler than this. But this is the one the teacher says they want me to do a lot. Okay? So that's Peng Lu Jian. One, I'll just do it once from here. And then I'll do it once a little bit more smoothly. Okay? Good, so now you're ready for the super advanced, and so Renee will come up. You guys are just like the fastest students of all time. Thank you.